Hi guys and welcome back in Medical Scribe. This video is the 10th video in the Introduction to Anatomy series. Today we will talk about the anatomical position. In anatomy, we have something important, which is that all anatomical descriptions that describe the human body are expressed in relation to one consistent position. This thing occurs in order to ensure that the descriptions are clear to everyone and not ambiguous. So, all of us when hear this description, we have a baseline in our mind. And the explainer will describe the human body structures also on the same baseline that all agreed with. So, this is standard position called the anatomical position. This anatomical position is the standard reference position of the body that used to describe the location of structures. Alright? Okay. So, the body in anatomical position must be like this. First of all, the person stands upright and erect, on the upper limbs adjacent to the sides, while the lower limbs close together. So this is the general appearance of a person in anatomical position. While the details are, in the face, the mouth is closed and the facial expression is neutral, not laughing or crying. The rim of bone under the eyes is in the same horizontal plane as that of the ear opening. The eyes are open and locked anteriorly. While the upper limbs, as we said, on the body side, the hands also on the body side, and the palms face forward or anteriorly. The fingers will be straight and together, except the thumb, which will be in 90 degrees to the other fingers. And lastly, the lower limbs also, as we said, close together, and the feet must be parallel and together. And the soles of the feet are on the ground, and the toes point forward or anteriorly. So, this is the standard anatomical position that adopted globally. That means all persons who describe the human body must use this position. So, if we use this position with appropriate terminology, we can locate all structures' location and relate any part of the body precisely to any other. And also, we can describe all directions and movements, like if the person flexes or extends his arm, because it will be based on this anatomical position also. Finally, we have to keep in our mind that there is an exception to this anatomical position, which is when we describe the internal organs of person while he stands upright. The gravity causes a downward shift for these internal organs. Alright? Good. But, when we examine an affected organ, the person typically be in a supine position. That means we will describe the organ location while the person is lying down or in supine position firstly, and the second thing is that the position of this organ will be slightly different. Because there will be not the same gravity on the organ here like the gravity on it when the person was standing. So this is almost all exceptions in anatomical position. And that's it. I hope what I said makes sense. See you next video and goodbye.